Hi again and welcome to part 2 of the How to Program series. In this part I will explain you everything what's inside the template script that Unity gave us in the last part. So for the ones who don't know my name yet, my name is Matthijs and I will guide you through this series. In the first part we created a new script. We called it first script. If you don't already open it up by double clicking. So I assume you don't have any idea what all those code mean. Don't worry, after this video you will get the idea of what those lines of code mean. So let's start at the top of a script with those two first lines. The first one is saying using Unity Engine and the second one is saying using system.collections. Those two are importing a sort of library containing different kind of functions that we can use inside our script. You need to have those two included in your script, otherwise it doesn't work. When you create a new script, those two lines are added automatically, so you don't have to worry about it. But be sure that they're always there. The using word is saying that you want to use a library. In this case, it's the Unity Engine. This is the name of the library. And the second one is using the system.collections. So take the collections library from system, or the other way around, go to system and take the collections. You can just forget about those two, but be sure that they're always at the top of your script. Then we kind of have our script itself. It's this section. Let's start with this line of code over here. It says public class first script mono behavior. So what is it saying? We have something public and the thing is a class, then we have a name and then mono behavior. I think you're very confused right now about what this line means. Don't worry, you'll get it in a moment, and otherwise you get it later. Let's start with the word class. Class is a sort of container for all our functions and variables. So everything you write inside the script should be inside the class. Then the next thing is first script. And this should be the same as our script name. So this is the name of our class. And this name should always be the same as our script name. So if we, for example, change our script name inside Unity. So let's say we call it second script. We also have to change the class name to second script. Then we have this mark. And then it says mono behavior. This defines the type of a script. In most cases, you need to have mono behavior. And this word lets you use some kind of functions inside your script and tells Unity what kind of script you make. By default, it's always mono behavior, so you don't have to worry about it. And then back to the first word, it says public, and this defines that we have a public class. So Unity can easily access it and other scripts can change variables inside this script. So the only thing you have to worry about in this line is that this name of the class is the same as your script name. Then we have this opening curly bracket, and if you click on it, you can see that this one gets highlighted. This is the scope of our class, and the scope defines from where to where your class goes. And in this case, we started over here, and we ended at the end of a script. You can see that all those functions inside here are inside our class. So every time you open a bracket, you should always close it again. You can also tell that this part is inside the class because of the white space over here. These words are all aligned to the left and these are all one tab indented. You can also put it right here. The code works exactly the same, but for humans it's easier to read if you indent it one space. So you know that this part is inside the class. So every piece of code you write should be inside your class, so between this bracket and the closing bracket. So this is our container of all the things we make. Then we go inside the container and check what the first line does. It's this light gray line with two slashes at the front. This means that it's a comment. Two slashes mean that the whole line is commented. This doesn't do anything inside the script, but it's only to clear out your script for other persons or to remind some things. In this case, it says use this for initialization. So you know that this function you can use for initialization of your game. so when you start the game, you have to use this function. As said, this doesn't do anything, so we can write some random stuff in here. Let's say this is a comment. So when you write two slashes, it's a comment. If you don't use those slashes and start to type, you can see it's black and you get a bar with no completions found. But if you write two slashes at the front of this, you can see it's turning light gray and now it's also a comment, so you can write whatever you want in here. It's very nice to remember what the code does when you make a very big script. Then we see our first function. It's this section. Whenever you see void, you know that it's a function. Void is a type of function. So a void function just runs the function and then goes to the next part. You also have other functions which return something, but a void just runs the function and goes to the next part. Then we have a name, and the name of this function is start. And this start name comes from the mono behavior. It's inside this library, such as the update. It's also coming from mono behavior. So these already have a own task. Then we have two round brackets, open and close. These don't do anything right now, but you must place them here, otherwise your function doesn't work. And then we open the function with a curly bracket and we close it again, also with a curly bracket, but then the closing one. The start function and the update are some special ones because they are called at certain points. Start gets called once when you start the game. So if you hit the play button, whenever you have a function with start, it will run once and then go to the next part and never run again until you stop the game and play it again. So the start function is only run once at the start of your game. So we have a quick look back. We have a type of function void. Then we have a name, open and close it with the round brackets. And then you open the function by a curly bracket and close it again, also by a curly bracket. Then inside the function, you can do something you want to do at the start of your game. So for example, spawn the player. And to remember, we should place that code over here. We can use a comment, so two slashes. And then we should spawn our player here. So we know that in the future we can write our spawn player code over here. We can remove this comment because it doesn't do anything. So just highlight it and press backspace a few times. Then we go to the next part. It's this section. And we also have a comment over here. Update is called once per frame. This exactly says what this function does. The update runs every frame. So it's about 30 till 60 times per second. So where the start function only runs once at the start of a game, the void function keeps running over and over 30 times a second. We also can remove this comment because we don't need it anymore. And the same way the start function works, we have a type of function void, then we have the name, and this name is coming from the mono behavior. It's a standard function. Then we open and close it with the round ones, and open the function with the curly bracket and close again with also a curly bracket. So everything that we want to do over and over again in the game should be placed in the update function. And for example, we want to move our player. So also write a comment over here and say move player code. So we know that we need to place our code that moves the player over here. So at the start of a game, we should spawn a player once and then over and over move the player. This is the basic setup of a script. So we have something you do in the start and then you have to do something over and over again in the game. So this bracket closes the update function. If you highlight it, you can see where it goes to. And this one over here closes the class because we're done with the script. Always remind to save the file. So go to file and then save. And I think that's it for this episode. In the next episode, we're going to move this cube with our script. I hope you kind of understand what this script means. So thanks for watching and I hope to see you in the next part because that will be a lot of fun. And for now, bye guys.